balik sa GMA Regional TV Live, mga kapuso, sa spotlight karong butaga, hisgutan ta og paladman pa kini mga kaso sa COVID-19 karon sa atong katilingban. Paminawon ta kining kasinatian sa usa ka pamilyahan taga lungsod sa Cordova, mga kapuso. Wa gyud damhang duha ka miyembro ang mitaliwan gumikan ning maong sakit. Atong paminawon ay ilang istorya og kapanaminan alang sa atong mga kaigsuonan diha. Makauban ta karong buntaga si Sir John Tabasa. Mayong buntag, Sir John. Welcome sa GMA Regional TV Live. Kumusta ka karong buntaga, sir?
Thank you, Sir Nick. It's a privilege kay ko to be here, no, and be able to spread the advocacy regarding sa COVID-19, especially karon nga nang lisod na jud niya a lot of friends na fad og other family members na naapektuhan na jud sa virus. Pero yeah, laban lang gihapon.
Tinuod jud na, Sir John, murag everyday nigmata nato, mutanaw ta social media daghan kitag makita nga mga naigo, mga naapektuhan nga mga pamilya nga murag nagkaduol na gyud, sir, ang virus ug nagkalapad gyud ang naapektuhan sa atong katilingban. Sir John, can you take us back to the moment, sir? Kanus ama ni sir, kani yung mga family members apil na ka, sir, na igo sa COVID-19?
My brother started his symptoms mga late to end of June. Mm-hmm. We weren't expecting it could have been COVID. It just started as fever lang, no, low grade fever. And then wala ra jud check off or any other symptoms. Mm-hmm. So we suspected maybe basin flu or basin dengue gani. Pero as it turns out nga pagkadugay-dugay na he developed siya cough. Mm-hmm. And also ni develop fever akong father. And then lastly, when we decided to admit him, kay medyo nag-check na siyang oxygen saturations ni baba na siya below 90 na. That's when we decided to get him admitted. And then once na-admit na silang duha, ako po ni sugod na po ako ang symptoms, which was started as a fever po. And then, yeah, may nilisod na akong ginhawa gamay, inana. And then I also developed a little bit of cough. And then what the loss of taste and smell did, mm-hmm, which is considered po sa akong mild symptoms, which is layo ra po kayo sa ilaha. Then my mother was the one nga primary caregiver nilang duha sa akong dad, usa akong brother. And then knowing ako ra po ang vaccinated, so dako kay siya nga risk. And knowing I also had to work every day, Monday to Friday, so mabilin jud sa akong mom and with my dad and my brother. Mm-hmm. To na-admit sila, it's really hard po thinking akong mom ra mabilin sa balay. And then knowing all the risks for isolation and ana, so we really had to work out a system, no?
During that time, Sir John, ikaw ra ang nabakunahan pa sa pamilya.
Yes, ako ra.
During your previous interview, sir, imo yung gi-highlight ang importansya nga makapabakuna na, Sir John. Why is that so?
Yes. Because I am fortunate enough to get the vaccine early. I will just not mention the brand, pero I was fortunate enough to get and privileged nga nakuha na akong vaccine early. And then when COVID hit our home, we literally did not expect that to happen, no? And to be as fast and as quick as 1 month, nawala na akong father and then my brother the week after. Pero makita jud nga, even though kaming tulo ang naigo, ako ra jud ang naay mild symptoms. Mm-hmm. So the only difference namo tulo is ako kay vaccinated na silang duha dili. So what else can we kuan nga effective jud ang vaccine, even though if vaccinated ka pero maigo gyapon ka sa COVID, at least dili ka maabot sa katong stage nga naabtan sa akong brother o sa akong father. Mm-hmm. Knowing us also, I'm also a health worker in one of the hospitals here in Cebu. Mm-hmm. Maybe even though listed siya nga message, no, nga gikan ni Lord, kay I just lost my father and my brother, pero I did not let it stop me without to continue the advocacy of promoting healthcare dere sa Cebu and also the Philippines. Now hopefully people would listen to the experts, dili lang si Tito o si Tita sa Facebook, no? Mm-hmm. Pero hopefully they would listen sa katong mga sakto o sa mga gitun-an jud nila o dugay, especially sa mga doctors. And then ako jud ang usa sa mga advocates nga epektibo jud ang vaccine for COVID. So, mm-hmm, yes,
Sir Nick. In closing, Sir John, kung doon na kay buot ipaabot nga mensahe sa atong mga viewers sa rong buntaga.
We hope na everyone will not lose hope. just continue to follow the protocols, mask up, protect yourselves, protect your families, and please get vaccinated. Okay, it's one of the best solutions to stop the spread of COVID-19. Thank you. Okay.
Thank you so much, sir, for joining us this morning and for sharing to us your story. Dakan kayong salamat ug amping diha, Sir John Tabasa.
Kamo po, Sir Nick. Salamat kayo.
Thank you, sir.